was indeed unique, as this classical style was sung in the Capibara language, which I believe was a first for North America. The featured performers, with the exception of our organist, Mr. Wool, have unfortunately all passed on. But I'm sure they are all looking down from heaven right now, having a good time, and possibly will be singing along with the CD. We will be playing you two selections of the CD further on in the program. Here it now is going to continue and give us a little background in history about the Hispaniola mixed choir, Nyama.
I guess that's it. That's all I have to tell you for now. And I'll skip you to come on. for 55 years. I'm tired. Thinking back, it's hard to believe how it started. I'm 15 years old. My dear friend Brenda Rice convinced me to join. I loved it. And then, after so many years, somebody said to me, you know, our elders, the older voices, they're leaving us. Who's going to sing for us? Who's going to sing for us when we die? What's going to happen? And it stayed in my mind. A few years after that, Louis here said to me, you know, Skip, he says, we have music upstairs. We have tapes. We have all kinds of stuff. He says, some are real to real, some are on disguise. He says, we have so much. He says, I don't know what we're doing. So I spoke with Mr. Chuck Barnett. I said, Chuck, we have some music. You think you could put it on a CD or a hard drive for us? Yeah, he says, I can try that. He mentioned, though, that some of the tapes we had were so old that he was afraid to put them on a machine, they might disintegrate. But he says, I'll give it a shot. Anyways, every bit of music that he had was put onto a hard drive, which we had. Mind you, it took a number of years and a little bit of money. The first thing we did, I paid for it because I said that's my gift to the church. And then we had a few other things. So right now, as it stands, with all of the money that was invested to make this, is a little over $20,000, which I think will be good because the money will come back to the church. You're all going to buy one, I hope. So when we got it done, Father Sear sat on it. He was ready to do it. He got sick, he had a heart attack, and he never came back to where he would handle it. Joni was working. Kathy Rice was working on it. She was working in church. She couldn't get anywhere with it. So we had four little demo CDs, which I gave to Annette and Vera, and they were listening to it. And every time they listened to it, they said, what are we going to do with these things? So they said, what can we do? I said, hey girls, I says, I have a whole hard drive. There's about 15 to 20 hours of music on it. I says, take it, do what you want to do. They found somebody at McGill, a friend of Annette's, and they got together and they went through this and they found the seven last words of Christ, which I've only heard one of the parts of it. So you're going to hear the rest of them. We have a lot more music to put on these. In my years in the choir, we went to Warriorsville many times. I think my best memory was in 1976, we went to sing at Ecumenical World Council in Philadelphia. And our choir was invited. We sang at Old St. Joe's Church, the oldest church in Philadelphia. At the time, Mr. Gould's mother, he was our organist, his mother was sick, he couldn't come with us. So we had some of the organists. He was a doctor of music, Father Louis Sear. He came and played for us. Anyway, we had rehearsed and rehearsed and rehearsed this mass by Charles Pino. It was a concert mass, and we got into the church. Everybody was nervous, but we sang. At the end of the mass, Father Sear picked up. He said, Skip, here, our little organ, he says, was a 10-stop organ. He says, that church had a 40-stop organ. He says, I had everything open, I had a pedal to the metal. He says, and I was giving them everything I got. He says, you guys don't know me. He says, never heard you sing better. That was my personal happiest moment. So, what we're going to have for you today, I hope you enjoy it because it's been a labor of love. It's been something that's very dear to everyone in the choir. And the other person I want to mention, because when I first joined the choir, she was always on my back and giving me a head. She said, pay attention, Esther King. She was just absolutely, she was good friends with my mother, so she thought it was her son, too, and she would smack me all the time and say, pay attention. So for all of those voices, Esther, Annie, Agathe, all of those voices that we used to hear, Earl Sailor, I sang with Earl Sailor in Philadelphia. It was just gorgeous. And Annie and Esther, the four of us sang one piece, just the four of us. Unbelievable. So they're looking down, they'll be listening. Thank you very much.
Yeah.
good thief, because the good one said to him, I want to visit you in your kingdom. So Jesus answered him, today you will be with me in paradise. And that sounds like animal hush. The first word was sung by Roman sailor. That's what Mr. Who listened to the chanting. He told us the voices, he knew their distinct voices, because he played the organ at that time. And the third word is, woman, this is thy son. That Jesus wanted Mary not to be lonely, to be taken care of. So she said to, he said to his apostle John, this is your mother, this is your son. That's the third word. The fourth is, Father, Father, why have you forsaken me? First one, right?
Thank you.
please come up.
Oh, the CDs, yes.
your shop right here. Okay, so you purchased one. They're gift wrap, by the way. Most of them are gift wrap for Christmas already. So if you want to give them to somebody, you're very welcome. So thank you so much for coming today and being part of all this. Really, really.
Thank you again, and before we go, the two people who worked so hard, Annette and Vera, thank you very much.